first we have to select a new file assembly. In this video we are going to see how to assemble the bearing. So select assemble and click OK. Here we have to insert the components which we created previously. So go to the browse and select our corresponding components. First we have to insert the outgrading of the bearing, place it at the corresponding position. Then we have to insert here few more components. Go to the insert component and browse, select inner ring of the bearing and place at the required position. After that we have to apply the mate between the two components. So select a mate, then we have to apply a concentric mate, select a corresponding faces of both rings. Select a two inner faces of the bearings, then just click OK. Then we have to apply a coincident between the two faces of bearing. So select a corresponding two faces of the rings and apply the coincident. Click OK. After that we have to insert a few more components here. So go to the insert components and select our ball, then click open, just place it at a corresponding positions. After that we have going for applying mate here. So go to the mates. Here we have to apply a tangent mate. So select a tangent, then select a outer face of the ball and the inner face of the internal bearing ring. Then we have to just change the mate alignment directions. Then you have to just click OK here. Then we have to make a pattern for creating a more number of balls here. So go to the circular pattern. Here we have to select a parameter as the outer face of the bearing ring. Then we have to select the component to be pattern here. Then we have to insert the number of instances to be produced. Make sure you have click the equal spacing. Then click OK. After that we have to insert a ball holder. So go to the insert components. We have to select the last component of the bearing assembly. Select browse. Select our ball holder. Then select open. Now we have to insert here ball holder. After that we have to apply the mate between the ball holder and other components. Just you have to show the all axes of the components, then go to the mate, select the outer faces of ball holder and outer face of the ring for applying the concentric mate. Just click OK. After that we have to just move the ball holder corresponding to the constraints. After that we have to apply the coincident mate between the ball holder axis and the ball axis. So select a axis of the both systems, then click OK. Now the coincident mate is automatically applied here. After that we have to make a mirror of ball holder, because ball holder is cover the balls on both sides, so we have to go for menu bar. Then we have to click a pattern. Inside the pattern we have a mirror option, so select a mirror components, select a mirror plane, center of the ball, so we have to select a just face of the ball holder. Then we have to select a component to be mirror. Our ball holder is to be mirrored here, so select a ball holder, then click OK. Now the ball holder is successfully mirrored on both sides. Finally we got a assembly of bearing successfully here. If you have any doubts regarding this component assembly, just post in my comment. Don't forget to like and share. For more doubts and discussions, in the description we have provided our blog link. So go to the blog link and follow for the regular updates of recording the mechanical CAD softwares. Don't forget to like and share. Subscribe for get regular updates of my video. First we have to select